2-14. Oh, I'm sorry, that's the one we just did. Michael, how come I don't have that? All right, so we're gonna shift, thank you, JD, we're gonna shift over to Matt. And you actually do have two cases, so let's look at CU 2021-04.
Thank you, Madam Chairman. You have two cases from the city of Valdosta, they are both conditional use permit requests. First one is by Blue Right Holdings, property located at 1006 Slater Street. Current zoning is RP. They are requesting approval for a family-sized personal care home. You may recall from previous requests, there's three different sizes of personal care homes, each with a different label. A family is up zero or one to six persons. Typically, we see those in single-family residential neighborhoods. This one is in what used to be a single-family house, but the zoning is RP, and it requires a conditional use permit approval. Property you see is to the south of the university, it's between Patterson Street and William Street corridors. It's an area kind of I call RP land, it's sort of a mixture of houses, historic in nature, this is in the local historic district, and many of which have been converted over to offices, and the subject property is no exception to that. Character area is transitional neighborhood, which denotes the history where it's been converting from residential use to something other than residential. Aerial imagery shows three houses in a row that are all converted over to offices a number of years ago. This one is in the center. These three share driveways, they also share an interconnected parking lot. So in this case, it's a former office coming back down into residential use, but residential in the form of a personal care home. Many times, we do not recommend or support personal care homes in a residential neighborhood. Six clients, usually four is where the cap ends, unless there's something unusual about the size of the house or the size of the property. Here, the size of the building and the size of the property are pretty regular in terms of single-family neighborhoods, but this is not a single-family neighborhood. Residential, in terms of its building character, the land use pattern is more intensive. So in this case, you see the site plan, there are seven parking spaces in the back that connect with its neighbors. Property, you see the residential look from the street. There is no parking on the street or in the front yards, everything is to the rear. Handicap ramp is already installed on this building, and I think the other buildings next to it as well, from years ago. Adjacent properties, again, you see the similar Craftsman-style architecture with front porches and small yards. The property across the street, interestingly, is still used as a single-family residence, but it is the anomaly in the area. So because this is not your typical neighborhood, even though the character of the houses are that of a single-family, we are definitely recommending approval of this personal care home with six residents, but with a few conditions as we normally put on conditional uses. And there's four of them as follows. Number one, approval shall be granted for a state license and fully compliant personal care home with up to six residents at the facility. No other uses allowed in RP zoning shall be allowed on the property that are in addition to the personal care home. Number two, all parking associated with the facility shall be located on-site and in the rear yard only. Three, there shall be no temporary signage, and permanent signs shall be limited to those which are allowed in the historic district under RP zoning and in accordance with the historic district design guidelines. And lastly, number four, initial use approval shall expire 2 years from the date of approval with no city business license has been approved by that date. And these are conditions that are typical from other personal care homes that we've had in a similar situation. Glad to answer any questions you may have.
Yes.
You may have said, with the amount of concrete poured in the back of this facility already, what was this previous?
Office, special office.
Yeah, I'm glad I missed that, you said that.
There was three offices in a row.
Okay, just curious.
Under the same ownership.
Right, so parking's not an issue if they do choose to go up to six residents?
Correct. believe, is proposing to purchase the property. They would then lease it to a personal care home operator. And you see it's described in the cover page here. It's a little bit different, but the applicant is related to the facility in several ways. Both as property owner, lease it to a company, and then one of the applicant's entities will also be a consultant to the operation of the facility. So basically, they're there.
Yeah.
Matt, did the, when it was an office, did they alter the interior layout or all the bedrooms that were?
Probably to some degree. To get back into residential use, they may have to do some minor renovation. There's no changes to the outside or doorways or porches or the site itself. If they did any of that, they would have to go through the Historic Preservation Commission. But from what they told me, it's already been pre-inspected by the fire department, fire marshal's office. Approval for up to six based on the floor plan. My suspicion is the office use that was there before did not convert a whole lot from residential to office. So going back the other way means probably not a whole lot of renovation.
Do you know how many bedrooms they plan to utilize in the house? Or?
I think it's three. Three for bedrooms and then other. Applicant can get into those details a lot more.
Okay.
Thank you.
Any other questions? All right, let's open it up to the audience. Is there anyone here tonight who would like to speak on behalf of this request? Please come forward if you'd like to speak on behalf. If you will, please just state your name and address for the record.
Fonda Blue, America's Road.
Okay, ma'am.
I'm Shonda. I'm the co-owner of Innovative Senior Solutions and Blue Bright Properties. I'm here with my business partner, which is my sister, Jessica Wright. We are sisters, we are both registered nurses. I've been doing long-term care all of my life. I got 8 years on her, so. But anyway, we both been working in the nursing home business, and in 07, our grandmother got where she could no longer walk, and she told us she didn't want to go to a nursing home. And so at the time, there was not a in-home care agency down there, it was locally. And we were hiring agencies from Columbus and Griffin, and there was just a lot of issues. And so we saw a need for our grandmother, and she became our first client. And so we started doing in-home care, and through joining associations and learning more about services we can offer to keep seniors in the community versus a nursing home. And there is a need for a nursing home, but a lot of people can't stay home in the community longer. We learned about adult day, and we learned about personal care homes. And we started offering those services as well. In 2019, I think we sold our in-home care business. And when we did that, we had to pivot. And that's when we started helping individuals start their own senior care business. We purchased property, we looked at ourselves. We like those nice looking homes like this. My litmus test is my grandmother can't stay there. Nobody can stay there. So we want nice properties. We don't change the property. We like that historic. We like the porches. We don't make any changes to the exterior of the property. We also provide consulting, and so we are connected to whoever is going into the property long term. We consult with them. We come in quarterly. We do compliance rounds. We check their charts. We make sure they're in compliance with the state. We also make sure they are licensed. We don't need their license. So we provide hands-on support to whoever the owner is that's going into the property. There's only going to be one caregiver there at any given time, so there's not going to be a whole lot of cars, and there shouldn't be any issues with parking. We don't do signs because we like for the homes to blend into the community, so there will be no exterior signage. I think somebody asked about the changes on the inside, so it is for 3 bedrooms. The only changes we had to make or are going to make is put in a shower, and we have to put the kitchen back in.
Is this for elderly or DD or?
This is for seniors.
Okay, for seniors, okay. Okay, any questions for our speaker?
No presentation.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
We appreciate what you do.
Thank you.
All right, is there anyone here tonight, anyone else who wishes to speak on behalf? Please come forward. All right, is Is there anyone tonight wishing to speak against this request? Please come forward. Anyone wishing to speak against the request, if you'll come forward at this time. All right, if there's no one wishing to speak against, we'll turn it back over to the commissioners for any final discussion. All right, there being none, I'll ask for a motion.
Madam Chair, regarding CU 2021-04, a conditional use request to allow a personal care home in the residential professional area, RP, zoning district. I move that we recommend approval to the city council with the conditions as elaborated on by staff.
Okay.
I second that, Madam Chair.
All right. All right, we have a motion to approve. We have a second, and that is to approve with four conditions as outlined by staff. Is there any discussion on the motion? All right, if not, all those in favor of the motion to approve, please raise your right hand. And all those against, and the motion